Alright, how's it going everyone? Welcome back to another Undisputed video. And another request video today from Reese Angle, or Angle. Sorry if I've butchered your name there, mate. But he's requested some King Ryan Garcia gameplay. It's been a while since I've played as him as well, so I'm due a gameplay with Flash. I've got a cousin called Reese, by the way. So old a fellow Reese. Who can we go against the... probably going to be Loma, isn't it? 90, I don't know. I've yet to box this guy's AI. Zukan. We'll go against Loma, I think. It's going to be a bit jarring playing this. I've just jumped from recording some Fight Night Champion gameplay. So it's always jarring for me, like... switching games one after the other. We'll go C7. Undisputed difficulty. Just bump this up by one. Let's go. Yeah, it's going to be so jarring. The when you hold L2 or LB, depending on what controller you're using, to plant your feet so you can, you know, move at the waist.
Ladies and gentlemen,
it feels way more. Alongside me, way more fluid in Fight Night Champion, and way more, the range of movement is increased by a lot compared to this game. This game feels like very stiff and upright in that department. I harp on about this all the time, but one of the biggest changes I would like to see in this game, apart from some like animations and stuff and, you know, things like that, is the movement at the waist needs to be like increased like massively. Like, you know, you get some of those like old school Mexican boxers, was it like Cesar Chavez, Julius Cesar Chavez, and that Mexican pressure style, and they'd like almost do like a full 90 degree bend at the waist when they were like bobbing their head and stuff, and, you know, attacking the body. And it's just extremely limited in this game, and I don't feel like I can fake my way in with like bobs and weaves, you know. I just feel like it's a bit too upright, and I would love for them to change it. But whether they will or not, I don't know. I just feel if they did that, it would level the game up just that little bit much more.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner from Victorville, California, here is the exciting boxing sensation, introducing King Ryan Garcia. Fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the two-time Olympic gold medalist from Ukraine, a tremendous three-division champion of the world, Vasiliy Lomachenko.
I'm also noticing as well, I don't know if it happened just a few seconds ago because I was talking over the top of it, but when the arenas load in, when the match, well, sort of when the gameplay starts, the announcers will announce the arena, the wrong arena. So they probably called this the WEC arena, and it's happened in a couple of my videos, and I'm noticing the call in other arenas the wrong name. So I don't know if that's a glitch that the devs are aware of, but it's happening on almost every arena I play on now.
There's an uppercut, a big uppercut, and his knees buckled that time. He gets out of the way of that left hand. Not too many seats to be had in this arena as the hype continues to build for this showdown.
This is not just hype. We are in for something special tonight. What an arena.
Oh,
what an
slinging in the pocket, the two of us. Builder.
Exchange punches. There's a scoring blow.
Loma doesn't care about stamina. Look at him, he's fucking used it all. What's going on with his stamina? Oh, hard liver shot. Oh, and another one. And Loma does a fucking superhero landing. Fucking lands on one knee. Let's have a look at that liver shot there off the 1-2. Bang.
Bang.
God, he just used all of his stamina up there. I would like to play as Loma a little bit more. It's just that I'm shit at using southpaws in combat sports games. It's like I can never throw my combos like the way I can when I play as orthodox. I should try and learn, really. You know, just... oh. Just like spend a few days just learning how to use the southpaws and trying to throw my combos the same way, but it's just going to take too much fucking time. And I know it pisses a few people off in the comments when I use southpaws in the orthodox stance, but it's just easier. It's easier to do that rather than learn how to use them southpaw, and, you know, who gives a fuck at the end of the day? You know what I mean? Oh! Right, straight stuns him at the end of the round.
But that knockdown is going to be huge. Can make or break a fighter.
Having me way with him here. Yeah, there's a couple of southpaws I'd like to use, like Usyk and, like I say, Loma. And, you know, I think there is that. There is a trait in this game where it's like a boxer can, you know, be equally as effective in either orthodox or southpaw. And if the boxer hasn't got that, then they're kind of slower in their opposite stance. So it would benefit me to learn how to do it, not just for this game, but for, like, you know, UFC games as well, and, you know, the southpaws in those games and stuff. I will try and make the effort to learn eventually.
Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go, because you know they're on shaky leg. They're a nuts here away from getting stopped.
He loves a fucking Nazi here, does Johnny Nelson, doesn't he? God, he likes that one.
Counterfighter relies a lot on their instincts and reaction time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
If you're fighting a counterpuncher,
you've got to dummy a shot. Make them react from that, then react then. I know it's hard to think that way, but counterpunchers, they're watching you, watching your every move, that every twitch. Counterpunch. I don't think it's going to be a boxing match. This is going to be a fight. Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
So close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
We're at the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. Still could go either way.
This really does feel incredibly stiff and upright. After coming from champ, just playing Fight Night Champion, like about half an hour ago. God, I just wish this would bend forward more. It's driving me fucking nuts. How it doesn't, it's just so stiff. It doesn't feel like you've got that sort of boxer fluidity. Like, this movement is awesome. I love the footwork in this game. I think it's done it one of the best so far. Like, the foot, every foot placement feels like it has weight behind it. But just
strategy.
This movement at the waist,
I
don't agree with the approach that they've taken with this. I mean, it's halfway there. All you need to do is be able to, like, bend a bit more.
As bad as boxing,
you know, like, weave from left to right while you're in that, in that sort of low, hunkered down posture. I just wish they'd change that. That's one of my biggest gripes with the... with the sort of, you know, planting your feet mechanic, and, like, look at it, it's fucking awful. I just don't like it. I haven't liked it from day one. I thought I could get used to it, but it just doesn't feel right to me.
Both want a highlight reel knockout. Looks like we're going to see an early night here. He is rocked. Has he weathered the storm? How are they still standing? Punch. What is this fighter doing? There's nothing behind these punches.
Do a bit of loose movements. I never use this at all.
Punch, counter punch. You're a power puncher. You're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. Just like a match made in heaven.
and forth they go in this round, the momentum continues to shift.
Oh, liver shot and then a power straight down the middle.
Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
Here we go to the fourth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. The counter left. Big left there, but misses. In the past,
ooh,
this fighter,
course,
they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment.
It's the one who draws first blood, Tom. That's what you've got to look at. If you hit and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be on it, but you've got to be confident.
Good left counter that lands.
Oh, for the sweat fly off his head like a sponge. Like he dipped the sponge in water. Oh, he's trying to fire back though. Oh, big left over the top. Gotta be careful. Don't want to be getting a, you know, undisputed dice roll KO.
It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other. Because no one,
those dice roll flash knockouts.
This has been a very competitive round between these two. Better start respecting each other's punching power. That counter shot lands. Counter punching.
Check right up over the top there from Loma.
And they get out of the way of that left hand. Nice counter shot. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one.
Another big left power left from Loma there.
There was no doubt about who won that round.
Dominance, without a doubt, made look so, so easy.
And there's the bell for round five. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. The old adage is, no matter how much speed you've got, timing keeps speed.
Put me back on my heels, that one.
Gifted with such hand speed, footwork, movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
And he misses with that jab. They're giving us a high tempo show.
Oh, check right up again for Loma.
Did not work on defense this training camp.
Oh, and another one.
You've seen all the famous boxing movies, the training scenes, the gym work. That's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them more than happy.
He just misses hit that jab.
Don't have a stamina.
And just as quickly as it slows down, it heats back up. Close round with 10 seconds to go. Catch and shoot with the left
liver shot counter.
They've got the momentum. They've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight.
There's the bell for round six. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Nice counter shot with the right hand.
Oh, hit me there. Wasn't paying attention to me, head health.
Is he out on his feet here? Apparently no rest for the weary. Thought about taking a breath, but instead, they're in there throwing bombs again. Why aren't they defending? Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Good counter left hand there. Defend yourself at all times, but this fighter hasn't defended themselves at all. Big shots from both of these fighters. Got to be careful, though. Counter right.
I very, very rarely get flash knockdowns or KOs in this game. Like, for countering the... I tend to get them done against me. I'll way more than I do actually get them against the AI. I think I've only had like about 4 or 5 since I've been playing the game. They just very rarely happen. In my favor, at least, anyway. Just seems like they've not quite nailed down like the... how the flash knockdowns and knockouts work. It just, it all seems very random to me.
Bell to start round 7. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round.
Like, there's been a bunch of counter shots landed in this fight, and from both of us, and you think at least one of them would have warranted some kind of, like, you know, flash knockdown at least.
Talk about punches and bunches. That's the mantra for this fighter.
Which we get it with one now.
This can be so frustrating when you remember such a fast fighter that can throw 3-4 shot combinations before you've even let one off. That creates frustration, and that's when it gets hard.
Nice counter punch.
Oh, hitting that. Oh, when he takes a knee, fucking superhero landed again. Off the lip shot.
On their feet, but I'm not sure why.
But now it's about getting back to the corner, freshen up, get new instructions given to you, and they've got to gear you up. They've got to tell you what you're doing wrong and what you're doing right.
Not a lot of defense here at all.
The one thing Todd Grisham hates, it's lack of defense. Like, fucking hates it.
He fails to score with that left hook. As we enter the final 10 seconds here, it's probably a round he'd rather forget.
Oh, he uncorks a couple at the end. Oh.
What a huge momentum swing that's going to be, considering that round will be 10-8 after the knockdown.
You've been put down. You've got to think right, survive, and then give it back the next round.
And they're back at it again here in round 8. He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if...
Oh.
No, we don't see a knockdown.
I feel like I just have to spam a load of shots there when he's in the stun state to just to fucking get his block down.
This fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
Work the body, frustrate them, take the mind off the chin, take the mind off protecting everything around that. Work the body, use tactics sometimes to sort of clutch you out, block the fight, and beat them on points.
This fighter has determined that they can walk.
Fucking hell, see what I'm saying? I have to hit him so many times just to get his block down. Unless I throw power shots like...
Step back, compose yourself.
Oh, he hit me then.
Then move, then step it up a little bit. Because if you're getting caught like that beginning, you get caught a lot more at the end.
Shots, even if they land, are going to do no damage. And it appears they weathered. Can he close the show? Much better game plan here. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. And now it's him that's in trouble.
Beautiful.
There we go. Finally, fuck's sake. Oh, right up to the body and the left hook up top after it.
This next round is going to be crucial considering the knockdown we just witnessed.
Love the response though. Got back up. Took a deep breath. Got light. Push it up. Get on.
There's the bell for round 9. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
Oh, listen to me. If I knock somebody down like that, that round, you know this round coming out? He's getting everything, everything, full barrel because I know his legs are gone. So this, you watch what's going to happen. If he doesn't, I'll be very, very surprised.
I think it's safe to say one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
What you've got to do, Toddy, is anticipation. Ooh. You've got to wait. You've just got
big
to throw caution
counter
to
left
win.
Straight there from Lomachenko.
You're never going to know where the shots are coming from. You've just got to put in a guess.
Sort of the death by a thousand paper cuts approach. He'll hit you a thousand times
there, but
before you can land one.
He's used all my stamina up. Oh, that left straight's got me worried.
Nice exchanges from both men in this trench. He misses with that jab. No stamina, no injury, but still throwing punches. In the early rounds of a fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know you've got a chin that is not going to get dented.
That forward step pivot is starting to piss me off now in this game. It's like the AI just does it so much, and it's like it's doing it too much. Do you know what I mean? It's like, look at it. It's annoying now. It's like I was liking it at first when it was doing it, but it feels like every other fucking move that it's making now is that annoying sidestep pivot.
There's the bell for round 10. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one.
Look at it, just constantly doing it. Even fighters who are not really known for that kind of movement.
Coming back to life now.
So like, do it. I know what you could fucking argue differently because it's Loma, but... You know, maybe they've upped his frequency of him doing it. But I just feel like it's... Whoever you fight in this game, there's the same kind of AI pattern, you know. They all fight like this, even
the same.
Even Ali fights this, like this.
Chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like a crisp.
Can he finish the job? Can he finish the job?
Power straight there off the jab to the body again. Feel like you have to use power shots here to get through the block, otherwise you'd be there all day unloading combinations on them. Like, they can always recover in time. I feel like you'd have to power shot them to get through the block. They can take too much damage on the block.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
That looks like it's gonna be it. There he goes, finally got him out of there. Cue the Bridget Jones's Diary knockdown animation there where he rolls back onto his bed and thinks about a future relationship with somebody. That's what that animation looks like. So I hope you enjoyed the gameplay, Reese. Thanks for the request, mate. If you want to request the gameplay, by all means, feel free. If you'd also want to request one and... You know, there's a donation link in the comments there if you want to help old Livershot out a little bit and get a request at the same time. Feel free to click that donation link. But anyway, I'm going to leave it there. Thanks very much for watching, everyone. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.